Alrighty.
All right.
Welcome back.
Welcome back you know what's a crazy statistic?
Oh, what's a crazy statistic?
The New York Times actually voted us the most political podcast in gaming.
Ah, I love politics. So,
because we keep talking about like Joe Biden and stuff, like,
yeah,
how much of a big gamer he is and stuff. You know what I'm talking
about?
What
games do you think Joe Biden will play? He's like, think about it, he's like 80, right? Yeah. You think he'll play like something like Banjo-Kazooie or something like that?
He looks I don't want this to actually turn political, but like, because he's got like Alzheimer's or whatever, like he can't remember shit. Like, I feel like him playing like an esport just would not go well at all. Like, even if he had like cracked aim, I feel like he'd just forget. Like, like, wait, we're on defense?
What the fuck? Wait, it's 8-4? Wait, when did we get on offense?
Yeah. Not even to like shit on Joe Biden. I just feel like that's how it
can. No, this man's brain is literally rotting. Like,
it's not to get political or anything.
For our non-American audiences, Joe Biden's our prime minister of your country. He's like essentially the president of our country. He's the president.
I think people know who Joe Biden is.
You think so? What if there's that one listener who's like, who the fuck is Joe Biden? They don't know. Maybe thinks like he's an actor or something, you know? But yeah.
I don't know. See, like, I read this thing one time where, like, you know how we look at Florida?
Yes.
Apparently, that's how the rest of the world looks at the U.S.
Damn. See?
I saw that on Reddit one time.
I honestly
I don't know if it's true. I could totally see it though.
Oh yeah, no, we're fucking weird. I feel like we just do everything weird.
No, it's just like the wackest fucking shit goes on here. It's like, I don't know.
Like Walmart, you know, like people like a joke.
Yeah, like Walmart people exist here.
Is there Walmart outside of America?
I don't know.
Maybe that's why they don't have the craziness. There's no Walmart. Holy
imagine,
shit.
Imagine.
Oh my
god. They put like a Walmart in like Amsterdam or something. Okay? And then suddenly like all the fucking like not mentally ill people, but like just whack as fuck people just start coming up and they start like lurking and it's like, that's what's doing this.
Yeah, see, you guys think we were the weird ones. No, it's just Walmart.
Like, we got a Walmart like 15 minutes from here. You know how many whack people are in fucking North Jersey?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie to you. I haven't been to a Walmart in like 2 years. I've never stepped inside of a Walmart in like,
you know,
2 years.
My father regularly shops at Walmart. And
like, unironically?
And it shows.
Like, unironically?
Yeah, like today he was like, yo, you want some beef jerky? And I'm like, sure. And then he gives me the bag. And it's like a no-name brand of beef jerky. And I'm like, where'd you get this? He's like, I got the value pack at Walmart. And I'm like, I'll pass on the beef jerky.
But, damn, is that why we're so weird? Shit. See, because like, you know, I'm Middle Eastern, so I go to the Middle East, but I don't tell people I'm from America. I mean, I tell them I studied and I lived there.
They probably like could tell that you're from America, though.
They could tell, but I tell them I was raised here, but I just lived in America. I just tell them that they understand. Oh, I gotta explain to everybody, the Middle East, they don't like Americans. It's not a racist thing.
I feel like that's not even like,
it's not a racist thing. They just don't like Americans. I've done a study.
I feel like that's not even like a, did you know? I feel like everyone knows that.
It's common knowledge. I'm not going to lie. Surprise, guys. I know Middle East don't really like you guys. I'm just going to be honest. If you go there and you say American, you're going to not get robbed. You're going to get like scammed. Just saying. Alrighty.
Oh, so it's not necessarily like violent acts. It's just,
no,
like,
they're just going to ramp
like
the price.
Oh, I could pull the wool over this guy's eyes.
Yeah,
maybe,
you know,
upcharge him for fucking taxi or something.
Yeah, they'll upcharge you for taxi because over taxi, it's not like an Uber. It's like an actual, like,
it's like a taxi.
Like an actual taxi. Yeah. Like, they run meters and shit. They still do that there.
Yeah.
So there's really Ubers over there. There's actually like, you have to go call a taxi. Like, there's an actual company, like, not,
yeah,
Uber. So
yeah, it's like New York taxi.
Yeah. So it's interesting. And you know what I've noticed? See, ever since Middle East, they got into more esports. I've been looking at more esports, like Middle Eastern esports org. And in Valorant, they have their own Middle Eastern league in Valorant. I look at that and I was like, oh shit.
Now, is there like a specific part of the Middle East that is has more players in it? Like, I'm asking because I don't know. I don't want to sound like the Middle East is poor. That's not what I'm saying. Like, is there like a region that it would make sense to have more people in it?
What I've seen personally, I've seen more Egyptians and then some Jordanians. But like, it's kind of and then Saudi Arabia is trying to get. I mean, Saudi Arabia is like huge, and they're trying to get in. The UAE is trying to get in. Mm-hmm. Just the Middle East. So don't say I'm racist, because I'm literally Jordanian and I've lived in the Middle East half my life.
I think you're racist.
So I'm not racist. I just know how the shit runs over there. So they've definitely fell behind. Like, socially, they're very much behind. Business-wise, they're not behind. But when it comes to socially, like social activities...
What do you mean?
Like, let's say the UFC. I think the UFC is now being held more fights in Dubai and like all those Middle Eastern countries, mm-hmm. because Saudi Arabia wants to get more involved. So they're having more countries. They're having the UFC. They had the WWE. They're having like more of those events.
They're trying to like bring more like mainstream mm-hmm. things into,
because they don't really have much mainstream shit there. Their business and like their wealth is there. Don't get me wrong, but like it's just socially and mainstream
shit. Have
you
seen like fucking the United Arab Emirates?
Oh
like,
yeah.
When fucking 90% of the supercars in the world are in fucking what city?
Interesting fact.
Dubai, maybe?
To show your wealth over there, it's by your license plate. It's not by your car. So the lower the number of the license plate you are, the more wealthy it shows you are. So for example, the number 11 license plate was bid and auctioned for $2 million or $2 million over there.
Oh, so like license plates over there is just like, here's number one. Here's number two.
Yeah.
It's not like
it's
here
auctioned.
Where it's like random.
Like Bugattis, Lamborghinis.
No. I'm saying like license plates. Like, are you talking about like my license plate?
Like
on
if
my
you
car?
Want a custom license plate and you want to show your wealth, the lower the number it is, the more wealthy. She's like, oh, all right. It's like everyone has Lamborghinis, Bugattis over there. But then you're like, oh, the shit. He has got the number 5 license plate. Holy shit. He's important. So like that's how it's run over there.
Interesting.
And so it's not over here. I mean,
so what if you put that on like your Honda Civic? Are people gonna be like, damn, that guy's sleeping on some cash?
Yeah, no. If someone tries to like scam it and be like, oh yeah, you know, I got the 5 license plate, I think you actually get like sued and you can get in big trouble. Like, you can go to prison time.
Interesting.
Like, they don't fuck around over there. One thing over there,
they don't fuck around.
With the flex. No, don't fuck around over there with wealthy people. They're actually like, they're nice people. They're like, they'll like, they're very accommodating, but if you just fuck with them, they'll be like, all right, like, are you
have
like,
you ever fucked a wealthy person?
I've never physically fucked a wealthy person. No. Why would you think I fuck a wealthy person?
I don't know. I just want.
No. What'd you say with your chest?
When's the last time you showered? No, I'm kidding.
Oh no, but like the Middle East is actually like there's a lot of. I mean, recently CS:GO, they had the last year. What was it?
Oh, the CS:GO.
No, they had a major event and they had it in Dubai. They had it in Dubai. Mm. Like, so that was like the first time in like ever, I think, they've had it in Dubai, in like the Middle East like that. Mm-hmm. So it was like pretty shocking. So then like, you'll start seeing more and more. And then like the Middle East is kind of like an interesting spot where they're trying to get more into esports, but then like they're just getting very mainstream. So if you notice a lot of Middle Eastern like shit going on being mainstream and all that, just notice it's slowly starting to happen because they realize, oh wait, we have money, why don't we actually use that money to be advanced socially?
Yeah, and then that draws more business for more money.
Yeah, no, like especially esports, like now if you look at esports, you're starting to slowly and slowly see more like events happening.
Can you envision a world where Middle East gets its own region?
It technically does. It's called MENA. It's like Middle East. It's like, so EMEA. It's Europe, Middle East, Africa.
Yeah.
So Middle East already technically has its own separate region.
I'm saying like you think the Middle East would be big enough? So then I guess it would just be EA for Europe, Africa, and then Middle East.
Is their own? I don't think so. I think they're not ahead socially to the point where they can have their own. And then I think I don't think so. They're expand regions because they already they did Americas, which is North and South. And then they have EMEA, which is all of that. And then Asia, which is like Japan, Korea, China, all that.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think they're actually going to expand on regions. But they would have like some, maybe like EMEA would probably be their own sub region to qualify for the main EMEA. And they might have that. Mm-hmm. But like when it comes to like their own region, no, I don't think so. It's not popular enough. Let's be serious. Like the Middle East is not really that popular compared to other countries. Like, when have you ever heard somebody really be like, I'm not going to lie. Like, I don't really hear many people say like, I want to travel to the Middle East for vacation. No, it's just because we got to think about it, right?
I think it's also like current events.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. Like,
you got to understand.
The whole Middle East is a war zone at all, but it's like what you see in the news about the Middle East kind of scares me.
Because
people.
If you think about it, right? If you go and you place, if you make an event and then like this, a country over is having like a...
A fucking
not,
war.
If there's like a war going on, it's like, it makes no sense. For example, like, I mean, for example, like you have Russia and Ukraine right now. There's the war going on. You're not going to see any of, I mean, it's...
You're not going to see an event in Poland right
now.
Yeah.
Just because like, you got to think about, it's not like your country's under, it's just because you got to think about like social events. So it's also going on. People are be like, oh no, I don't really care. But like, you might not care because you're the viewer, but you got to think about the players, the staff, the coaches, the teams. Like, you got to think about that. Like, you guys got to understand, like, social events. That's why in Saudi Arabia, nothing was really going on. Like, Saudi Arabia is like, nothing's happening. There's no war around there, nothing. So that's why if they have it over there, if they have it in the UAE, mm-hmm. you'll see events there because, like, nothing's going on. It's just a bunch of wealthy people spreading their money.
Yeah.
But,
I like it.
No, yeah. It's going to be interesting. I would definitely, I would see more events in the Middle East. I mean, I would love to go. I technically have a Jordanian, passport, so I'm chilling, but.
I don't have a passport.
Do you actually not?
No, I don't.
Wait, why?
I've never been like out of a U.S. territory before.
You
so,
serious?
Like, the only time I've ever been off the mainland U.S. is I've been to Bermuda, except that's a U.S. territory. So wait. I don't even think I needed a passport to go there.
So you're telling me, if we got invited to Japan to go for the Masters...
I have to get my passport mad quick, bro.
Bro, you would have... What the fuck? Why did you... I thought you had a passport.
I've never needed one.
I thought everyone, just common knowledge, everyone just gets a passport.
No, you don't... It's not like something you just get.
I know,
like,
but like...
you have to go for it.
Like for me, like when I went, I got... The funny thing is, I remember this clearly. I went a month before 2020 started and I got my passport and then like... COVID started hitting and then everyone's got fucked over because the passport just took so long. So mm-hmm. I was like clear. So I have a passport for the next 10 years. I mean, starting 2020. So yeah, I got seven more years of like my passport. What the fuck? I thought everyone, I thought it was just like a common thing. Everyone just, okay,
no,
just get a passport.
Like if you never have a reason, if you're never planning on leaving the country, then, or at least like in the foreseeable future, why get it? You know?
Didn't we talk about this where like, if you're in esports, you should have a passport?
Yeah. If you're a player.
Or like you're part of like if you're going to events, huh? So if we get invited to Japan, you got to get your passport quick as
fuck.
Yeah,
I was actually thinking about that the other day. I need to like apply for that like
now. I mean, I think what I heard is that you can actually pay to make it quicker.
Yeah,
I think you can. I don't know if you want to spend the money. I think it's like what, $50.
It's not the worst.
Yeah,
better than like 5 months that some people are waiting.
I mean, Champions is going to be in America and it might be in LA. We should go.
Yeah. Like, we go to that, no problem.
All right, bet. So, if you see us in what? That's in November, I think. So, if you see in November, we're going to be in LA for Champions. Mark our word. We're going to come back to this episode.
Who's Mark?
That guy, Mark. You know what I mean?
I don't know, Mark.
You don't fucking know Mark? Bro, he's been like, we'll talk about this later. Fucking hell. You know what I've realized over the time? This is a hot take. Speed running should be an esport.
An esport?
Yes. I think speed running would be a sick ass esports to watch. And in my opinion, it'd be more entertaining than battle royales.
Okay, so like what games are you talking about speed running?
We'll talk about Elden Ring. All right. So we can make boundaries, right? So we're like, okay, we'll make some rules. Like, as for example, we get like 20 people, right? Be like, all right, guys. I'll give you guys an hour. Whoever gets the best time in speed running, and whoever gets the best time in that 1 hour, you get like you get multiple tries, and you fuck up, you can restart all that, right? You can restart, but if you get whoever gets the best time in that hour, you mm-hmm. win like a prize. And I feel like that'd be sick as fuck. It could be multiple games. It doesn't have to be just one. Speed running is its own category, and it could be any game.
I actually Oh, I forget what his name is. I'm going to look him up right now just to make sure I properly represent. But there's this guy who hosts these like competitions for like Elden Ring speedruns, except it's not like finish the game as fast as you can. He has like a thing where it's like you have 1 hour to beat as many bosses as you can.
Oh.
So it's not finish the game. It's like there's like 100-something bosses. Let me see.
I think that would be actually more interesting because then it forces you like, all right, what kind of build should I get? Or like, what's the track? Wait, that's actually can you just keep going off of the same boss over and over again?
No. By Amazing Chest.
He does that?
Yeah, so he hosts a bunch of these. Let me see.
Because I can see that. That actually sounds so much fun to watch. Beating Elden Ring.
How fast can you beat Milena from a new game?
Oh, wait, that's actually so sick.
Elden Ring, but you only have 30 minutes to level yourself, and then everyone PvPs.
Wait, that actually sounds so sick. What? Wait, I could see that being entertaining as fuck.
Yeah, and he has like a bunch of these for like a bunch of the Souls games, but like, I watched the video, and he put like usually 20 or so people participate in this, and he like basically does a recap of like the top two, and like they're like, okay, we're gonna skip this boss, we're gonna go here and get this weapon, and we're just gonna farm for a couple minutes to like get it out, and then they go back to the starting area and just try to one shot as many bosses as they can to just knock them out as quick as possible. And it's like, it's kind of cool how like watching the because it forces you to be creative with it. Because it's like, if you're just gonna finish the game as quick as possible, there's like optimal routes that people have found. So it's really just gonna be everyone doing the same thing who just does it better. But like this, it's like people are gonna have different approaches to it.
Yeah, you can be more creative. So you can build like a full strength build, let me build intelligence. Like,
yeah.
You can be creative with it. I feel like that's like, see, that's something that actually is entertaining. Like, you would watch that, and I feel like that's so entertaining, which, no knock to Battle Royales, but I feel like it's so hard to watch as a viewer. Like, playing the game, don't get me wrong, playing a Battle Royale is fun.
I assume this is probably how it goes, but, like, there needs to be, like, some sort of, like, when they stream a Battle Royale, they need, like, one camera operator for every squad, okay? And then when two squads are fighting, the people who are operating the cameras of the ones that are fighting have to like press a button, and it's like, I get priority, I'm going on the screen right now, so that you're not watching
like it's from like an outside
like a
sky view angle.
Yeah,
because at that point it feels like I'm watching a MOBA. If that's the case, I feel like that's when the one thing I hate, like, I love Battle Royales. Like, genuinely, it's a fun game. Like, Apex, I love Apex to death, right? But it's just, like, sometimes watching a Battle Royale is so, like...
It's a lot more fun to play one than it is to watch.
Yeah.
One.
It's one of those games where you definitely... It's more fun to play than watch. 100%. Like, Fortnite, no build mode? Oh, my God. Genuinely, I had a good time. Like, me, Noah, and, like, John, we were playing that when it first came out. And I was like, wow, this shit is actually mad fun. Like, Fortnite was fun because there was no building. And if they did like a no building for Fortnite, I feel like it'd be more entertaining to watch. Because the competitive scene is like fucking dead. Like,
it's like, build a castle!
Yeah.
In point 1 second. Like, no, you watch the kid, there's that video of the kid's mouse, and he gets fucking shot for like 1 HP, and you just see his arm like, and then suddenly he's fucking like at the sky.
He builds like Eiffel Tower in like 2 seconds.
What?
No, yeah, I mean that's a turnoff when it comes to Fortnite. Like, if you look at every other battle royale, it's mostly just a shooter. Like, Fortnite is more, don't get me wrong, it's definitely more catered to the casual audiences. You can definitely tell.
I feel like if we were like 8 years old when Fortnite came out, you would totally be a Fortnite kid.
Do you think so?
I think so.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of it right now. I mean, anybody who is 8 would be a Fortnite kid, I feel like, right? For example, like, okay, if Fortnite, CS, and Valorant all release in the same time, which game do you think you'd more vibe with?
At 8 years old?
You're eight years old. All those three came out in 1 year. Boom, boom, boom. Which game would you think you would actually like play and you think you would actually like vibe with more?
I think... Okay, so this is taking into account like how I was like raised, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But like my parents, if there was like some shit in a game or whatever, would never buy it for me.
Yeah.
So like if there was like the battle pass or some shit and I see all my friends getting all these fucking cool ass skins and whatever, even though I don't know how much is the battle pass, like
$10.
$10, my parents would be like, that's a fucking waste of money.
Yeah.
Like, you know how long, like, I got Minecraft so much later than everyone, because, like, the only times that I ever got, like, games or things was my birthday or Christmas.
Yeah.
So, like, I personally think, with that into account, I would probably, but, I mean, they used to not have the Battle Pass in Valorant.
No, they have always had the Battle Pass in Valorant. They've always had it.
I mean, well, the Battle Pass doesn't have, like, all the cool shit in it. Like, I mean, it's got some cards in it.
Like cards and sprays that you might use once
a year. But
like
the skins, like if you're just going to buy them, it's what you just buy the bundle one. So I think probably Valorant, because in my 8 year old head, I could be like, I get more of the game if I play Valorant, you know?
Yeah. I think with me, I would still argue that I would be with CSGO just for the sole reason that
you feel like a big kid because it's more mature.
Yeah, no, straight up.
That's
like,
actually fair.
No, like when I was younger, I was like, damn, I played CSGO. There's surfing. There's 1v1 arenas. There's like, it was because I don't, because in Valorant, there all you can only do is like comp, unrated, and like swift flight, like, right? Mm-hmm. But like in CSGO, like, oh, if I, you know what? I don't feel like, I want to play CSGO, but I don't feel like playing. I'm just going to go and surf for like an hour straight. I'm just going to go vibe out, play music, put a podcast, watch a video on my second monitor, and just
see,
vibe out.
I'm thinking about that, and like, I agree with what you're saying, but me as an 8 year old, I think I would quit the game because I would think it's too hard.
Huh, really?
Like, I think I, like, in my fucking 8 year old head, I would not understand that you can't run and shoot. Because thinking about what I was playing when I was fucking 8
like
and 9 year old,
and all that.
I was playing fucking Modern Warfare 2 in 09 when I was 9 years old, and fucking COD, World at War when I was 8. So like I would probably get on CSGO. And I mean, it'd probably be similar to Valorant.
Yeah.
So maybe thinking about it, I would be a Fortnite kid. Even though I never fucking liked Fortnite when it came out or anything, but at 8 years old, I would probably think Fortnite's the easiest out of all of them, and that's why I'd play it more.
Yeah. I think I would try Fortnite first, and if I sucked at building, I'd be like, dude, I just want to shoot people. So then I'd either try CSGO and Valorant. I would maybe lean, I would be CSGO first, right? I was thinking about it. I would play CSGO for a long period of time, and then of course, if I'm 8 years old, right? I got no job. My parents don't really give me an income. I only get like same thing with you. Like I only got it for birthdays. If I did really well in school, like all that shit, right? So I was thinking like maybe I would go CSGO, and if I can't get a lot of skins, I just play Valorant on the side. But I would go, it would go CSGO, Valorant, and then Fortnite in the end, because mm-hmm. like I just didn't like Fortnite. I never really liked Fortnite. Maybe even the, like the no build mode, I played it for a little bit. I had fun, but I was like, I'd rather play something else.
I still think other battle royales are better than Fortnite no build mode.
Prime H1Z1, Prime PUBG. Like, those were, in
Prime
my opinion...
PUBG is, like, some of the most fun I've ever had.
Oh,
in gaming. 100,
yeah.
Like, I'm not even fucking kidding. Like, I wish Metal was around from back then, because, like...
There were some... The interactions you had with... Because that had proximity chat.
Yeah.
It had proximity chat. So, PUBG and its Prime, you meet the most interesting human beings.
Mm-hmm.
People always say, oh, you meet interesting people. No. These are interesting, but they were funny as fuck people. Like, they were genuine. They had some
people
actual...
People beg for their lives and shit. Or,
oh my god, what was that one clip? There was this one clip, I remember at old PUBG Prime, where some guy, he started playing, like, Quran. Like, guy doing the Duan to Quran while someone was, like, on the floor. And I was like, you can't make that shit up. You can't... That was Prime PUBG, where it's... You don't know what's gonna happen. You're going to go into a game and you're going to like, you're going to be on the ground. It's like, bro, just kill me. Like, no, they'll just make you listen to the most whack shit. And then you would have to leave the game. Nah, PUBG in its prime was good. H1Z1 started it. It did a good foundation.
I never played H1Z1.
I played for a little bit. It had a good foundation, but PUBG literally did that, and it was like, let me crank it to 100. It did it so much better. Then it like died out. Then Fortnite came. All the kids started playing it. Then it was like, it blew up, you know? Apex had its little shine a little bit, but it's always felt like it was under Fortnite. And now it feels like Apex is so much better than Fortnite. So I like how the history of Battle Royales is kind of shifting so much.
Even though I feel like not many people are really playing Battle Royales as a whole.
I feel like it's not... They are. There's a lot of people playing it, but compared to, like, of course, like, first-person, like, tech shooters, it's not being played as much. So, like, of course, Valorant's a new hot thing. And you also got to think about this. One thing I've noticed about each game is how developers respond to the players. That is the one thing I've noticed, or how each game feels different. Like, Apex, like, what I'm seeing from, like, Apex Twitter and all that, like, some of the developers don't give a shit while some of the... Look what they say. Like, hey, your server's trash. Why are all your servers trash? Mm-hmm. Yo, this agent is busted. Why haven't you nerfed it? And Valorant, I think that's why Valorant is so popular, is because the developer to community ratio and how they listen is so tight.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, yo, like, okay, hey, Chamber is fucking busted. Can you find a way to bust it? All right. Hey, we heard your complaint about Chamber, but we're trying to find a way where he's not, will we nerf him? He's not he's nerfed, but he can be somewhat playable. We're trying. So that's what I think the biggest thing about each game.
Yeah, that's why like everyone quit Fortnite, because fucking they just stopped supporting it. Like, you ever see that video? It's kind of funny, but it's also kind of sad. There's some like Fortnite pro who's literally fucking like crying. And he's like, the developers don't care about the game anymore. How are people like me supposed to make money if the game is just full of cheaters? And yeah. It's like, Fortnite.
It's Fortnite. I mean, that's why you see like so many Fortnite pros literally move to feckin' Valorant, because I mean, the game, I know the gunplay is different and all that, but like they can adapt.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I feel like, no, like people who play Fortnite, they were mechanically skilled. Like, they were.
Like, your movement's good if you play Fortnite at like a high level.
If you play Fortnite at a high level, then you move to Valorant, I feel like you'd be cracked. Like, CS player pros, gunplay wise, they're cracked. Move like Apex pros, they go move over Apex and Overwatch pros, they move to Valorant, their util placement is really well. Like, that's what makes Valorant so good compared to others. It's because it takes little bits and pieces of so many other genres and is like, hey, let's do something great about it, and this is what we're doing. And that's why, like, it's interesting to see, like, because I know CSGO right now still has more numbers than Valorant, but you're definitely going to see over the time, because, like, let's be serious, Valve doesn't really give a shit about their community. I'm not going to lie.
CSGO really has more numbers than Valorant?
Still, so far, they've had...
In viewership or in player base?
Player base. Player base. Like, player base, like, it's still very dominant in, like, Europe. I know it's kind of dead in America, but people still play in America. But, like, it's kind of dead here when it comes to the NACS scene. But, like, in Europe and, like, Russia, all that, like, it's massive still. Still, like, one of the number one games played. Like, everyone just plays that game. Because, I mean, let's be serious. Like, for CSGO...
There's a reason Valorant exists.
Valorant... And unironically, Valorant killed the NA scene of CSGO. Unironically,
NA CSGO was kind of dead.
They were kind of always dog shit. It was what? Only Team Liquid and, like, EG.
It was, like, when C9 was good, it was... And then when, Liquid was good.
Liquid was good in 2019. And then after that, like, it's only been Liquid and then Complexity. Like, they have a CS, but, like, they're not really, they're okay.
There's not enough NA representation.
No. God, no.
For, like, anyone to care.
Nobody really, like, and then a lot of the NA pros going on, they're just playing unpaid. Like, they're getting little to nothing.
Really?
Like, that's nothing. Like, even if they stream, like, what are they getting? Like, it's pennies compared to what Valorant pros get for streaming. Like, you see, like, a Challengers pro, like, even if he's, like, the bottom fragger of a Challengers pro, he can still make so much money on the side by just streaming the game.
Yeah.
Because, like, it's popular, it's good, it's big, it's, like, accommodates to so many people. But that's why it's, like, Valorant killed the NA CS scene. So, it is what it is, but, like, it's technically Val's fault as well for not even fucking caring about it. So, that's always interesting to see. But, no, yeah. That's why, like, yeah, Battle Royales, hard to watch. Speedrunning, I would say, is interesting. Because I saw this one video.
I like those speedruns of, like, trying to get banned on Twitch as quick as possible.
I'm seen some of those TikToks.
They're so funny.
Bro.
They're fucked up.
They're so stupid, but I love... It's so entertaining to watch. Like, he'll go live, he'll say, like, I don't know. I don't even
some
know...
Some racist shit or something.
Or he'll say racist shit, or they'll just go naked. And then they'll just get banned instantly. And I'm like, what the fuck? Because people are under... Like, I don't know, like, if... Because you can't, like, if you do some shit like that, it's, I don't even know if you, I don't know if it's a permanent ban, a temporary ban, but it's like, dude.
I think if you're putting your dick out on stream, that's a permanent ban.
Yeah.
I mean, don't quote me on that, but I feel like that's what should be the,
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to freaking put my willy on the screen.
It was like, oh my, it was like a couple months ago. This girl, she was live streaming, right? it got huge. I remember this was fucking huge. She was essentially getting fucked from behind.
Oh, I heard about
that.
Yeah,
she was getting fucked from behind, but the guy's POV wasn't, but she was like making like struggling faces. Like, and then she got a 3-day it was like a 3-day or a week ban. And everyone's like, so you can have sex on Twitch and you can get a week ban, but if I accidentally say I'm gonna beat the shit out of someone as a joke, I get a whole month ban. Because someone compared it, because somebody else was joking, be like, I'm gonna beat the shit out of you as like a joke, right? Mm-hmm. And then he got a month ban. But someone getting fucked got like a week ban. So it's like, what the fuck?
Maybe it comes down to what's more entertaining for the Twitch staff to watch.
No, I think Twitch is slowly gonna... Yeah, well, Twitch is so fucked. Because like you saw, like now there's like other platforms, like YouTube is starting to grow a little bit more when it comes to streaming. I know Trainwreck's made his own like Kick. Like it's like a rival to Twitch, but it's sponsored by a gambling company. It's run by a gambling company.
Oh, that's good.
So, you know what I mean? I don't know if it's good or not, but it's just like...
I think Twitch just also has the culture. Like, the streaming stuff started...
With Twitch, yeah.
With Twitch. Like, I feel like even if you make a banger platform, it's just the culture isn't there. Like, remember when Mixer came out and fucking, like, Shroud and Ninja... Mm-hmm. Move there, except it still wasn't pulling the numbers, so they fucking like killed Mixer.
To be a benefit of the doubt, it was during COVID, and they said even Shroud and Ninja came out, they're like, yeah, we had so many events planned to just blow up Mixer, but due to that COVID hitting and nobody going out, we couldn't do it.
Really?
Yeah, they said they had plans, and they're like, yo, we had events going, we had like something like TwitchCon going, we had like so many things going on, and like, yeah, it was fucked, because then everyone who got banned from Twitch went to Mixer.
Yeah.
And then now Mixer's gone. It's like, yo, I got no platform. I got no income. What the fuck am I supposed to do now? So then, like, they begged Twitch, and, like, Twitch, like, unbanned some of them. They went through a list. They unbanned. And I don't know. Some of them are they're either streaming on YouTube or they're going and, like, they're, like, I don't know. They're getting they go back to Twitch. But,
is it really, like, that hard to not get banned on Twitch, though?
I mean, remember when they said you can't say virgin? I can't call someone a virgin and incel. You can't call anybody that anymore. You get banned for saying that.
I forgot about that.
So, like, it's that thing was like, dude, like, you're kind of like, if you call someone a virgin or incel and you get offended by that, come on. Come on.
Just have some sex, man.
Just, you know, have sex. I don't know what to tell you. Stop being a virgin then. It's not that hard, guys.
We're all gamers.
Yeah,
we just stand there. It's pretty hard.
But no, it's just like, that's also the I don't know. The culture, yes. I see like Twitch, like, you know, Keck W, like all that stuff, like Pause Champ, like all that. That is where the Twitch culture. Pause Champ?
Did you just say that?
Yeah, it's a real emote. You don't know about Twitch, Pause Champ? You know what's interesting? Before I recorded this yesterday, Noah was like, yo, you mind if I come on the podcast? I'm like, what are we going to talk about, Noah? And he's like, I'll just quiz you about Twitch. And I'm like, Danny doesn't know shit about Twitch.
That'd be so funny.
Yeah. And he's like, yeah, I just present to you some emotes and you just tell me what it is. And I'm like,
it would literally be like that fucking TikTok trend where it's like having my girlfriend name Valorant characters or whatever. You ever see those? Or the Overwatch one is really funny. Yeah.
No, they were funny. That's why I'm like, dude, it's just gonna know it. Danny's just gonna say like the most dumb shit. He's gonna get everything wrong. It's not gonna be even a remotely fair competition.
Yeah.
My man's not really like watching Twitch. He's barely on Twitter.
Even when I do watch Twitch, I don't even like participate in the chat.
Oh yeah, I don't like, participate either.
Like, I don't know. I watch people like for the content. I don't watch it to be a part of the content, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
I feel like that's most.
I don't know. I feel like if you like participating in Twitch chat, I'm not trying to knock you, but like, if you're just being a fucking gremlin all day and donating your fucking savings to Twitch chat, it's like, what the fuck? Just like, go outside.
Well, no, I do think that it's, you can donate it to only, I feel like smaller streamers do deserve the donations and the subs and all that. Like, yeah, for me, like, yeah, I'm subbed to, like, some of the content creators that I know, I'm subbed to them. Like, I have my Prime sub, I use my Prime sub on somebody, I, like, or, like, of course, when I, like, if I have extra money, or if I know, like, when I get, like, I don't know, like a good, like, a bigger, like, a better job, and I'm like, you know what, like, hey, let me support you a little bit, I'll support them, but, like,
yeah,
I usually support them here and there.
I'm talking about, like, hard simps, though. You know what I'm talking about? Like,
are you talking, okay, are you, what I think is,
like, there's a difference between supporting a creator and being a fucking gremlin.
I can see where your point is. I think I know where your point
is. So, like, I'm saying, like, say for the podcast Twitch, okay? We get a couple subs and whatever. It's like, cool, thanks, guys. But then, like, fucking, I don't know, little Johnny, not even, like, he makes his own money and whatever, but he's like, oh, I put half my paycheck as a donation. Me, as the person receiving it, would be like, the fuck are you doing?
Like, we're like, yeah, don't put large sum of money to,
like, if you want to throw a couple dollars here and there, it's,
yeah,
like that, then shit adds up. Like,
or like, if you do, like, yeah, if you do, like, hey, I'm gonna sub to you, all right, that's like, what, $5 a month? Like, if you just sub to somebody, I feel like that's just,
yeah,
more than,
yeah,
enough.
Yeah, I'm not saying, like, I think anyone who subs to people is a fucking gremlin.
We're not saying that. I'm saying people who, like, throw, like, large,
like,
sum of,
say,
money.
Like, say I make a fucking paycheck of, like, $500 this week, and I put $250 in it in this fucking e-girl streamer. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, it's like, what we're saying is, never throw large sum of money to people who are, like, much bigger creators. Like, don't throw half your paycheck on a content creator like that. Unless it's for charity. If it's for charity, then yeah, go ahead.
That's a
completely different topic when it comes to charity, or if they have, like, an event going on, or if there's, like, something for a good cause, yeah, do that shit. But if it's like a creator that's not, like, I don't know. My thing is don't donate, like, more than, I would say, 10% of your paycheck. I feel like anything more than that, it's like, dude, that's a little much.
Don't, like, donate. Bro, this person doesn't know you.
Like, okay, like, newsflash, guys. Streamers, like, they don't really know you. They appreciate you. Hey, because I saw one thing with Miskiff, right? Miskiff even literally said, he, like, told his monthly revenue. He's like, yeah, this is my monthly revenue. I forgot the, it was a shit ton of money. It was literally, I think, close to 6 figures monthly. I think it was that. Okay. And he was like, yeah, guys, like, I literally tell you guys, like, you don't need to sub, you don't need to donate, I'm fine. He has sponsorships already, he has ad revenues, he can literally run on Twitch ad revenues.
Yeah.
If there's a big, they can literally get money like that. So, like, that's my thing about, like, Twitch stream. It's like, if it's, like, maybe a small creator and you want to support them, perfect. But as an advice, I would say, as an advice, I'm not your financial guy, just telling you, a guy that, you know, see people do this shit.
You're a guy?
I am a guy.
Okay.
If you donate, like, don't donate more than, like, 10% of your paycheck, guys. And especially if it's somebody else's money, don't use somebody else's, like, little Johnny, don't use your mom's credit card to donate, to sub to a streamer. Don't do that. Don't fucking do that.
You've definitely done that before.
I have never done that. I think I've never subbed to anybody. I've only used my Prime sub, which is free, which comes with Amazon.
Yeah.
So I've used that on, like, Summit 1G. Because, like, I've watched him for, like, 7+ years. So, like, I've used up my Prime sub on him because I just, like him that much. But, like, minus
you
that.
You like him?
I do like him. He's got a massive forehead, but I like him. Like, a ginormous forehead. But
I,
like,
hope he sees this.
I mean, he's probably never going to see this, but if he does, I'm going to stand by it.
I hope Stelly clips this.
Stelly's going to clip this and he's going to be our editor.
Summit 1G has a big forehead.
He has a massive forehead. I love him, but he has a massive forehead. But, no. He's gonna see this. No, I don't think so. Anybody.
I hope that clip blows up now.
No, he's gonna see this.
In spite of you.
What the fuck? He's gonna find my Twitch account, ban me, and unsub to me. Hey, I'm a 3-year.
I don't think he was subbed to you in the first place.
No, he's gonna.
Oh, he's gonna revoke your subscription.
He's gonna revoke and he's gonna ban me, so I can't sub to him anymore. But he shouldn't, because I'm just giving him free money. But, you know, it's okay, guys. It's all right. He's already making, like, a shit ton of money. He's averaging, like, 30,000 viewers. Doesn't need my money, I think. You should donate to us so we can go to Japan in June. That'd be sick, right?
Yeah.
But that's it for the episode. I think, unless we have anything else to talk about. Alrighty, guys.
No.
Thank you for watching. Follow us on all socials. I love you all. Bye-bye.